All right, Millie for two. What are they down to? 13. Down to 11. Getting close. Getting close right here.
Just accept it.
Oh, I don't want to have to. I'm going to look. Oh, ooh, ooh, ooh.
Okay, okay, hold.
Oh, yes. Woo! All right, so we put this into play. And then.
Dude, we did it. Boys, nice. We did it.
Nice.
We did it. Focus up, nerds. It's time to enter the arena. With me, Riley Knight, and joining me this week and every week, Toral Topple Severin, the mythic champion.
What, what?
And Jamin Kalf.
It's me, as always, unprepared.
That was pretty good, though.
Actually, I
had a feeling that is me, as always, was kind of already something.
I feel like you already had that one in the chamber ready to go. That was very prepared. If you hadn't added the bit saying that you just made up that you weren't prepared, I would have fallen for it.
Oh, okay, wait, let's redo that then.
Just edit this whole thing. Yep, okay, go back, yep. So we'll just go from the what, and then, and Jimmy Cal.
It's me, as always.
Ah, ooh. You really had a chance to do something different.
If you had the chance
it's to turn
it back
to... ever.
Yeah, exactly, you could have really flipped the script there. Anyway, so we got a stone cold banger this weekend. It's not even a weekend, it's Monday. It's the opposite of a weekend.
It's the opposite.
It's the opposite.
You could argue it's still somewhere weekend.
It's weekend adjacent. Actually, yeah, in a lot of like smaller European towns, especially in like Bavaria and stuff, they have the Ruhetag. They have the rest day on Monday because they have to be open on the Saturday and the Sunday, like the restaurants and stuff. So, I guess in some people, you know, if you're a hospo veteran, maybe Monday is your weekend. Anyway, totally irrelevant to the deck we're playing and the game we're playing and everything. Let's have a talk about Yarok Turbo Mill. This was sent in by alert viewer Jonas Ristimaki. And it's an A with two dots on the top, and I think Jonas is Finnish, so I don't know how to pronounce that, but I'm just going to take refuge in the anglophonic way of just mispronouncing things and say it's Jonas Ristimaki. And I'll tell you what a spicy one we got here. It's a creature-based mill deck, so we got Yarok obviously to double the triggers, but what triggers are we doubling, I hear you ask? A good question. Chill out, I'll tell you. Overwhelmed Apprentice, Wall of Lost Thoughts, Sage's Row Denison. We're going to be milling people out with creatures, boys.
I mean, a classic? No, I can't even call it a classic.
No, it's not a classic. No, it's
no one has ever done this in the history of Arena.
That's it. It's up and coming. It's the new. It's the hottest and freshest technology. We've played mill decks in the past. They haven't gone well. But Drowned Secrets has come out for another tilt at the windmill here. In addition to some actual factual good cards, like Enter the God Eternals is just a very high quality magic card. Drown in the Lock in this deck. They're always going to have a full graveyard. And so this thing's going to kill or counter absolute. It's a murder counterspell split card. It's like ridiculous.
They're always going to have a full graveyard.
Can't counter.
I doubt that.
What do you mean? Okay, turn one, mill them for two, mill them for four. Turn two, another four. Whatever. Like by turn three, they're going to have like 10 cards in the graveyard.
Turn three, mill another four, and then exile their graveyard.
Oh.
Oops.
Oh, dear. Okay, yes. All right. Well, that's what's known in the business, my friends, as a non-bow. Probably should have thought about that one. Is it too late to... Nope, we've already locked this one in.
Yeah, I think it's already like 2 minutes into the video.
That's it. We can't reverse it, and there's no way to edit a deck once we've started talking about it as well. So, oops. That's the way that one goes. But no, look, we're gonna have a lot of fun. We're gonna double some triggers with Yarok, and hopefully mill them out. Get them done there. I don't know, one or folly or fancy. See how that goes. Assassin's Trophy in case we come against Planeswalkers.
Talking about Yarok.
Go on. Oh no, don't do it. No. Oh no.
You know, if you like,
we had a good run.
There's lots of magic retailers on the internet.
yeah, there are. There's lots. Yeah.
You know, and
a varying quality
one of them
as
is ChannelFireball.com. And if you don't buy a wait, I'm getting something here.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Wait. No. Oh, it's time for a different ad. Today.
Oh, good. Thank goodness. Oh, wow. Okay, we dodged the bullet there. ChannelFireball.com, my friends, is. I can't do it. So what happened was, when we went into this, right, I was like, okay, you know, here's the sort of stuff we're going to talk about in the ad. And Jamin's like, no, I've got a much better idea. Just let me go with it. And then you can do your bit, right? So I was like, all right, that's fine. That's fine. It'll probably be pretty funny. And I just got blindsided.
It turned out to be pretty funny.
Yep, I just got Reaper is not freed. Anyway, ChannelFireball.com is your one-stop shop, of course, for all magic cards and magic-related accessories. Also a bunch of free strategy there, as well as a buy list, which at the moment is a 40% store credit bonus when you're selling your cards at CFB.com. ChannelFireball, it's probably not CFB.com, to be honest. What is CFB.com to go to? Let's find that out right now. This is not the ad that we were supposed to do at all. CFB.com.
It's Capital for Business.
Capital for Business. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've been looking for a place to buy and sell magic cards, you want to go to Capital for Business, a middle market private equity firm singularly focused on the success of industrial growth companies. No, that's not what we're supposed to do. Members of the Riley Knight Secret Club will notice that we've been sent an email about the ad reads we need to do. And so today we are talking about, what is it? Arena Boys, Twitter and Instagram and Command Fest coverage. Did you know, my friends, you can stay ahead of the game and join the conversation by following Channel Fireball on Twitter. Text coverage appears here. See gameplay from some of the best in the game. That's the YouTube. We're not doing that. Whoops. Get rid of that one. Stay ahead of the game and enjoy the conversation. Follow Channel Fireball on Instagram. Get a behind-the-scenes look at events. And Channel Fireball will be bringing you exclusive coverage of Command Fest Seattle featuring the Asian... Why did they pick the Asian Avenger and not me? I'm going to be there. Why is that the Arena Boys...
Stop. The Asian Avenger will be there, guys. Come on, woo!
No, but like, this is an Arena Boys video.
It's not how this works, Riley. I'm sorry. You don't have enough clout.
I don't have enough clout. I'm not on that Asian Avenger level of clout, apparently. Oh well, if you want to go and see and hang out with the Asian Avenger, a fan favorite of Arena Boys fans, I bet. No, that's fine. I'll just be a little second fiddle there. That's right. Anyway, channel5.com. They got a Twitter. They got an Instagram. They got all sorts of stuff. Go get across them.
I mean, Twitter is basically the last source of text coverage we have left at GPs.
Mm-hmm, like, that's true. Yeah.
You know, when you want to know how people are doing, you head over there.
By the way, so I've just thought about the comments that I've made about the Asian Avenger, and I've realized that they were pretty like full on, especially for someone as like vanilla and as mild as me. And do you know what I realized that this show doesn't have? We don't have any beef. Like we don't have a turf war with any other content creators. We need to start a rap beef, boys.
Oh, I thought like starting beef within our like.
Should I keep this? Rap. I think I keep this, right? Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Yeah. No, not like edible beef products. I mean, like we should start like a feud is what I'm trying to say. Yeah, yeah.
We can say some unpleasant stuff to this Kenobi guy.
Oh, no. He's very big and very mean, and he'll say nasty things back to us that are much, much nastier.
Oh.
Damn. The Asian Avenger,
does it have to be with other content creators?
I think so, because that's the safe... Like, that's the way we can have, like, the to and fro, because it drives engagement from viewers and fans, sort of stuff. So, you know, we get Asian Avenger fans looking at our video. And even if they don't like it, that doesn't matter.
Okay, just I never liked LSV. I say that.
I think we should probably pick a different... Okay, all right. Just all offense, no defense here. No, the reason I like the Asian Avenger is because he's a really nice dude. Like, I've hung out with him a bunch, and he's actually a very, very good dude. And so I think we would win the feud because we can be nastier than he can. So I think, like, LSV's got a lot of zip and zap. Like, he's got a razor-sharp wit, right? And
we can't handle that.
Exactly. Whereas the Asian Avenger, like, he's just a very good dude. I'm going
to
kill this.
We have to find that one person in the universe who's a bit less feisty than we are.
Yeah, that's it. That's right. You always pick on someone beneath you. All right, I think we should just kill this, right?
Yeah, we definitely need to get rid of that Electromancer. And then...
Destroy target.
I wonder if we cast the apprentices or not, because the Yarok does look pretty powerful. Like, yeah, I don't think we cast them. Yeah, we keep,
all right.
Keep them for now.
Okay. Now, should I attack?
Of course.
Correct plays with the Arena Boys. I hate it.
Well, they can haste something? I don't think so.
Yeah, what if they haste?
I don't think the Arclight Phoenix deck cannot haste anything.
No, but maybe they play something. Ooh.
Oh, baby.
All right.
Oh,
all right.
Baby. Here we go. And it's a blue creature as well.
So now we mill four. Yep. And how much do we mill next turn?
A
bazillion. Don't even worry.
I don't even know. It's so many. Like, again, numbers just don't go that high as far as I'm
also,
aware.
Also, we're doing that against an Arclight Phoenix deck, right? So that's
the thing. Yeah. Oh, against a Crackling Drake deck. This is tech. This is what's known in the business as hot tech.
We just die, right? That's just a fact.
No, because we can just kill them. There we go.
I mean, okay.
I was going
to
say...
Don't we have to do that beforehand? Is it CMC or power?
It's CMC.
Oh, okay.
So we can just murder it whenever. Just do it now.
Okay, good.
Just do it now. In case they get spell pierced.
Of course.
Classic.
Yeah. Don't want to get spell pierced. Even though it's not legal in standard, I'm sure people will find a way to play it. All right, so we get to scry 2 and then scry 2. And they mill like... 700?
For every one, they mill 8, right?
Okay, all right.
So they mill 16.
There's one Phoenix. Yep. We want this.
Do we?
No, we don't cast any more.
Oh, that's true. We just want creatures, don't we? We just want blue creatures.
I think we just want creatures.
Yeah, that's very true. All right. We can do better than that.
Yeah, it's not great.
Yeah, we can do better than that. Seeing as we've got another, we can look at the up to the next 8 cards as well. Oh, sorry, next 4, so a total of 8. All right, another 16 cards. All right, halfway there. Halfway there.
The problem is that halfway there is...
Okay.
They've got a nice full hand, don't they? Only 4.
I think we want the enter thing.
Yeah, get rid of this.
But
don't we want both?
I think we're just too slow.
I mean, I think we just want... Even that, this doesn't make, like, a creature that triggers any of our stuff.
No, I think we want the folio.
Folio as well?
Below the enter, right?
Okay.
And the question is, like, if they cast spells now, they get tokens and the Arclight Phoenix, and they kill us super quickly, right? Isn't that happening?
So then, how many... We've still got 17 to go. I think we just have to dig to blue creatures. Like, we just need a Wall of Lost Thoughts.
Yeah, okay, then.
That's why I thought that keeping the folio is fine. Then we can draw one instantly and then maybe draw another 2.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think that's
all right, good. Let's do that. So keep the folio. And then
we also
get to look at the second. Ooh, that's good.
Yeah, I think we want that.
We'll just keep this?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay. Sweet.
And then attack.
All right, get in there. Gain a little bit of life as well. That's nice. I think the defensive capabilities of this deck are actually quite high. It's just that in the air, they're not really at their best.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, blocking creatures is something easily achieved by, like, the 0-4 that mills, the other 0-4 that mills.
Yep. The 1-2 and this 2-3 here, they can hold off. I mean, maybe not this one so much, but still.
Also can't kill any flyers. Ooh, they're not casting free spells. Oh,
boo. All right. So there's Discovery. So how many Phoenix... Phoenixes?
Surveil.
2, 3 Phoenixes. How lucky.
Phoenixes. Nice. How lucky can one player be? Another Discovery.
So we're taking 9, 10, 11?
But they've got 11. They've got 11 cards left in their deck.
Yeah, but we just die. We draw the folio.
Oh, we draw the folio. Why did we put the folio on top of our deck?
No, we still gain 3 life. Right?
Yeah, okay, but then we take 13.
So, and we can't cast this as
we're
well.
We're exactly dead.
Are you joking?
We tried
so hard.
Hang on. If we'd done a Wall of Lost Thoughts, that would have been 8, and then that would have been 12. So we would have got them if we just found a mill creature.
Like a mill 4 creature.
Boo. All right.
Oh, well.
So close.
You can't win them all.
You can't win them all. And in our case, you can't even win one.
Of course, we got like our worst matchup, right?
Yeah, the absolute worst matchup. You're right. Yeah. So if we go to 13 and then we take 9.
Yeah, no. Yeah, we're just
exactly 13. Boo. Well, maybe they... Nope. They're
not throwing away any fairies.
They saw it. Man, it's annoying when your opponent can also count.
Yeah, that's a really tough matchup for me. Opponents who can count.
Mathematically literate
players. You never get that matchup because Riley said also.
What?
He said if your opponent can also count.
Can also count.
Oh, wow. implying that I cannot count.
Oh, right. Okay.
Very nice.
Yeah, good. Good, good, good. Well, I mean, in that case, it wasn't applicable to me either. I have trouble with numbers. Numbers are very hard. Numbers are very difficult.
I mean, they can also, like, you know, once they get really high, like, they're hard to pronounce.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah.
Just so unhandy.
Keep this.
Yep.
Do you know all of those fancy names that numbers can have? Like, there are sexy numbers and all that stuff?
Yeah, yeah. There's, like, there's imaginary numbers. There's irrational numbers.
Well, but they're kind of basic. But I mean, like, really specific numbers that have, like, a certain...
There's no sexy numbers.
There is.
There's no sexy numbers. What are you talking about? Sexy numbers. Okay.
When I was a kid and I watched TV at night.
How is this a thing? Why are there sexy prime? Oh, okay.
Sexy prime numbers that differ from each other by
because
six.
Because it comes from the it's a pun stemming from the Latin word six. All right. Okay. I will let that pass because I was going to say that seems like way too nerdy for a bunch of bloody mathematicians to have done. But okay, I
don't think we wanted to cast that one.
You wanted to wait. Well, I've got another one. I've got a spare lined up for you here. How do you feel about that? Just the land, right?
Yeah.
Easy.
But keep the wall.
Until we got the Yarok out.
Yeah.
Oh, Jamin, I bet you feel like a bit of a fool. I bet you feel like a bit of a turkey right now.
Why?
Because we've just played a 1-2 and they've got a 1-1. They're never getting in for damage. Mm.
Okay, sure.
Keep this? No? All right.
No, we'll find another
Find another land. We do have a bunch of draw steps. All right, no attacks.
All right, just, you know, some trivia.
Mm-hmm.
For the sexy primes are 5 and 11.
I've always said 13. They're sexy numbers. Yep, okay.
11 and 17. Oof. I'm getting a bit aroused.
No, stop it. This is a family-friendly show, Jack. How dare you? What do we excel
13
here?
13 and 19.
Oh, stop it. Come on. This is turning into ASMR smut. What do you want to
I don't like the Enter the God Eternals.
So I have three things for you, right? And you have to guess what they are.
Okay.
So what are narcissistic numbers?
Am I just saying go here?
Yeah.
Right, just saying go. Enter tap and go. Narcissistic, so something self-referential, maybe numbers that contain operations that include themselves to produce themselves or something like that. Like, I can't think of an example, but something that you can make, I don't know, I don't know, something that is self-referential in some way.
Yeah, that's basically correct. I mean, you got it from the word. Do you know how you could get there?
Go on.
So what you do is you have a number. I just take a random example of 153.
Wow, okay. Just any number.
Just any number. Yep. So and cast anything, or we still saying go?
Yeah, just pass.
Okay, go on. Sorry, Tuffle.
So it's a three-digit number, right?
Yep.
So if you use any of those digits to the power of the amount of digits, you add to the number itself.
Why does that
so 1 to the power of 3, 5 to the power of 3, and 3 to the power of 3 add up to 153?
But... Okay, first of all, who figured this out? And second of all, why did they need a name given to that?
Fun. Okay, let's be honest. If you made the effort and the whole commitment to get there, you can name that.
Yeah. It's like digging through some cave system to find a rock that's slightly different from all the other rocks.
Yeah.
So you can then call it, and this is not a joke, coming tonight.
Yeah. For example... Somebody made like a huge rock and it looked like a weird thing that doubles effect. And he's like, that's Yarok.
That's Yarok. Ah, very good. Very good, Tuffle. All right. Let's play Yarok.
No. It just dies to the thingy.
So let's play Ground Secrets.
Yeah. Yeah. So and then we'll probably play the wall.
Okay.
To protect. I'm no expert in this thing, but playing the creature last that doubles all you have into play stuff.
Yeah, it's not. It doesn't seem like the tech, but oh, mate, another. We're feeding the cats here. All right, Toffee, you got another weird type of number for us?
Yes, have weird numbers. Actual weird numbers.
All right, Jamin, it's your turn. You take this one.
Well,
I got the first one right, so
you didn't even get it right.
Yes, I did.
I'll say weird numbers have some unintuitive property to them. See, that's just about as good as Riley's guess. I'm sure it's correct. All right, no. I'm obviously much smarter than Riley.
Okay,
so right. I'll make the correct guess on the first try. I'll make a specific guess.
Okay. All right.
I'll say weird numbers are numbers
yeah.
that contain, you know, if you divide them into their factors, I think it's called prime factors. They always have three prime factors that all differ by 5.
Wow, your keyboard is really quiet. Is he correct?
No.
Oh, so even after looking it up, you're still incorrect.
But I'm learning what it is now, and it's pretty complicated. So I will give you the short. I think the short comment, the explanation is pretty cool because then you have no idea what it is,
okay.
And then you can figure it out soon.
Hang on one second. What do we want to do with this, guys?
Keep
the wall. Do you want to keep this?
The drawn secrets.
Oh, okay, sure. All right.
So that's how fun definitions are. A weird number is defined as a number that is abundant without being semi-perfect. Right.
Mm. It's abundant without being semi-perfect.
I know some of those words.
All right, like Jamin's jokes. They're abundant, but they're not even close to semi-perfect.
So now you have to only know what semi-perfect is. Of course, semi-perfect is like an undercategory of perfect.
Yes.
I mean, everybody knows what perfect is.
Everyone knows what a perfect number is, of course. I mean, you guys can explain because I know what it is. Man, we're getting we're just getting rolled here.
Riggedy wrecked?
We are getting riggedy wrecked, son. Yep, sacrifice two creatures. I wondered why they didn't make us sacrifice the Yarok in response to the
other
apprentice. Yeah. Oh,
I think that's one of the case of don't care, win anyway.
Yeah, don't care. I've still got all these. Oh my goodness. All right. So we've got a Wall of Lost Thoughts. That doesn't do much. What are they on? 24 cards. Oh, it's so close.
It would be much easier if they bring a limited deck.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or if they like click through their turns all the time instead.
Maybe
of
if they disconnected.
Yeah, it'd be also very. That's like one of our outs. All right, we're dead.
Great stuff.
Great stuff. Maths chat.
The problem, mill decks are so difficult to make work when people are actually playing Magic.
Yeah, against someone who's not playing Magic, it's really easy to win. Because if you
Although,
sit down...
like I tried that once. I played my mill deck. You know, I was like 12, 13. I think it was like one of the first times in the local game store I tried the mill deck.
Yeah.
Because, you know, every new player is into mill decks. Mm-hmm. And I sat down, my opponent, you know, shuffled up. And then he actually was not playing Magic for the entire thing, right? Like, he went turn one, Exodia, and then I just lost. Mm. And then, yeah, he was playing Yu-Gi-Oh! And... I still couldn't win with the mill deck.
Being a really good matchup.
What's that?
They don't natural draw it. You just mill their pieces and they can't win.
Oh, yeah. Milling their Exodia.
Keep this, right?
Yeah, keep that. Yeah. You know, I honestly thought that Yu-Gi-Oh! Joke had a solid...
I think you could have done better because immediately where I went to was like snap. Like, I sat down to mill them out, and they just kept redrawing their deck from their graveyard, so I couldn't beat them. So I thought that was the gear that I was going with. I'm going to cast a Wall of Lost Thoughts.
Yeah, blocking is probably good.
We need some defense here. We need to get up in here with some defense. All right, target them. I don't know why this...
Wait, which level are you? Is that platinum?
No, it's silver, dude. It's silver.
Right.
Okay. You know that I don't. You know that I deliberately tank my rating on this account so we can play like good games on Arena Boys. You know that I don't want to get up to like Diamond or anything. That's deliberate. That's not because I can't get there. Of course.
Why do people bring real decks? Like, come on, it's the end of the month. You should be somewhere.
I'll just block the Pelt Collector.
Just block both.
Oh, they can't activate. Sweet. All right. Yeah. Sweet. All right.
Because we mill all their lands now.
Yeah. That's why milling's so good. You mill over all their good cards.
You know, yeah, if you just, yeah, you just need to be skilled at milling.
Yep. All right.
Just pass.
Oh, well, I'll play a land first, Jamin. Come on. Uh-huh. Come on. Pro strats. Right, yeah. Pro strats.
I haven't played any of a lot of this standard so far. So
okay. So you're not sure if you should play a land if you can. Yeah. All right.
I don't know the great strategies just yet. Just block the Pelt Collector.
Yeah. I don't know what happens there.
No, you probably, look for...
Yep. Another GCG there. That's fine. I mean, if that's their whole turn. So you can't stop your rock, right? Can't stop your rock.
No.
Should I play this card?
Oh, nice. Thank you. Please.
All right. There's also some other pretty good gear you might hear later on. Can you smell what Yarok is cooking? I think is pretty good. They had paper, but we had Yarok. Oh, no, that doesn't work because then we lose. I guess it does work then, actually. No, that works really well. Toffle, we'll get angry comments if you don't finish off the maths chat.
Oh, the list of three?
Yeah, we need the last one.
It actually would have been funny. So the last one is fortunate numbers.
Fortunate numbers?
Yeah.
Just the two creatures, or do you want to enter the God Eternal?
I want to get rid of Pelt Collector here.
Right, I like that too. Let's do this. Get rid of you.
Fortunate numbers.
So what is it in China, the numbers that really is really lucky? Is it four or seven?
To be very, very specific, I think they have to be fortunate primes.
Fortunate primes?
Yeah.
Okay, well, seven's a lucky number in many, like, many areas or many cultures. I don't know. Right? So seven. Seven's a lucky prime. Or fortunate prime? Oh, no, we're getting hinged.
That's
I'm
a big
sure
hinge.
The way I understand it, seven is a lucky number. Like a fortunate number.
Seven is a fortunate number. Okay, all right. Yeah. All right. No, I've got no idea. What's a fortunate number?
Okay, let me just comprehend that for a second. I will explain to you. Math is so hard.
We'll
you
be
know?
Back after this. All right.
You make the game interesting. Your goal is to not lose until I find that out.
I'll do my very best, Tuffle. Ooh.
Oh, it's another Yarok.
Just play it, right?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, okay. Although we still don't have deep... We don't have great blocks. Man, what a combo the Great Henges is with GPG, GCG, although not very much anymore, I suppose. Now they've got all of them out.
I mean, some of us don't have great blocks, but our opponent does have a great henge.
They do. They do have a great henge. You move to the henge step, and they're gonna beat us every time. How you going there, Tuffle? How's the research going?
I'm so lost.
Oh, no.
All right, but this is working out, isn't it?
Okay, like, we're being attacked by 5-5 in the air, so I don't know. Depends on your definition of worked out, but sure.
No, this is fine. How many cards do they have in their library?
28.
Just chump the 5-5.
Okay. Take 5.
Yeah, and then draw something really good.
Draw something really good. All right, I'll do my best. In our deck full of terrible cards, I'll draw something really good. Island is a very good card, historically speaking. Man, are we dead again?
No, not quite.
Not quite. All right, because we can attack with the Yarok.
Yeah. So we play the Denizen.
Yep, so that gets them to 4. No, it doesn't. It doesn't trigger itself. Oh, wow. Yeah. What a terrible card. All right, yep.
So this now mills 10. No, 12.
12, yep.
I mean...
Okay, but look at all the good cards we're milling over. Yep, okay. Yes.
Oh...
down to 16.
Oh, it's fine. Yeah, so we attack with the Yarok.
Yep. Go to 8. We can block these 3. Yeah, all right. We're not...
Oh,
someone forgot to read the card Yarok. They desecrated. All right. Very good.
So now we're still kind of dead.
We're still kind of dead, but... not as dead as we would be. I think they've got another Skargon Hellkite. Yeah, of course.
All right.
Maybe that was just incredibly advanced BM, double blocking our death touch.
I'm not on top of the BM metagame.
The BM metagame, yeah, it's shifting all the time. Especially, yeah, there's been bannings this week and that sort of stuff now. So yeah, it's very, very powerful indeed.
Also, the metagame snapshot just always tells something different. Like the rankings just.
Yeah.
Nobody seems to have a clear opinion of what's going on in the metagame.
Yeah, it's very turbulent. That's right. Now, Toffel, come on. We've filled enough dead air. You got to tell us what these numbers are now.
Okay. So what I assess is you take a number. Okay. For example, 2.
All right.
Random example. And then you multiply all the primes like in order. So for 2, it would be 2 and 3 because it's only 2 primes.
Okay.
And then you add 1 and right. then you have... 7, right? So then you take the next number.
Okay, 8. Yep.
No, the next prime number.
Oh, the next prime number, 11. So 11, yep.
Okay, then you obviously make 11 minus 7 plus 1.
Okay, yep.
Just play the Denizen?
Pardon? Yeah, of course, yeah.
Right. Yeah.
Because 7 was the number we got from the using the 2, yep. like the 2 times 3.
Yep,
and 11 was the one that's the next one. And if that plus 1 is still a prime number, then...
That's a fortune number. So I mean, it's basically like getting a number and just doing a whole lot of real nasty stuff to it. And if it survives, it's lucky. It's fortunate.
Yeah. It's
perfect. Keep the 1-2 for future Yarok, as always.
So? Okay.
Yeah. Nice. To me, the fortunate thing would be remembering how to work all of that out.
Yeah, you got to be a fortunate mathematician to figure that one out. All right. Iron Crag Pyromancer.
We can kill that.
I think we just kill it.
Converted
manacles. What do you think?
Yeah. Out.
Well, with the Drown of the Lock or with the...
No, the God Eternals.
I think so too.
Yeah. Then we can beat them down.
All right.
We distract them by milling.
Fools.
What fools.
Yeah, what fools.
We're only a Yarok away from a real force.
Can I point out that we're playing against Black Tom Cruise?
Yep, you can point that out.
I don't know. Felt like something to mention.
Yeah, tickled you, did it. All right, so we need... A Yarok off the top's going to be pretty good here, seeing as we've got these guys to get going. Oh, not again. Not again, this improbable alliance. We've already... Oh, how rude. How rude is our opponent here?
All right, Oof. The milling is on.
All right.
Okay, yeah.
Drown Secrets.
Go. Yes.
Sage's Rodenizen.
Yes.
Get
Ding.
You. The milling Mill is two. On. Mill you for two. So what are they on now? 10. So we can...
We don't want to mill too quickly. We need to have like a huge burst.
But yeah,
they
that's
did
true.
Put the cards into their graveyard pretty quickly, so we did mill too quickly.
We did mill too, yeah, and the animation was pretty quick. Yeah, that's good. So, I never thought I would see double Bone Crusher Giant cast on my Sage's Rodenizen, but...
But here we are.
Here we are. So this is the real... Look at this.
This is the wombo combo.
This is 6 plus another 2. This is going
to
be great.
But do we want to do that now?
Oh, you want to just... You want to, like, go into burst mode?
I guess now it's too late.
It's too... We have to, man. We've got to get those numbers up.
I felt like we could have kept the blue mana up for the Drown in the Lock. Oh, yikes. I guess this one can't be countered, but we can still kill it.
We can still kill it, so let's do that.
Wait. Hear me out.
Okay.
Oh, they draw cards. I love it. Yes.
I don't think that's an option, though. Like,
why not?
How many cards... I mean, we're dying super quickly.
Yeah, we die very quickly. Yeah,
how
just
many
do
cards
it now.
I think, we just kill it. They've got 31.
Okay, other question. Do we want to play a card before?
That doesn't make
it doesn't matter.
A card. It's only,
instants or sorceries.
Oh, okay, right. Yeah, right. You got me.
So let's just make sure that we've got more than 6 in the yard. Oh, 18. All right.
I mean, if they have like 3 become immenses,
we're in trouble. Not you.
Oh, actually, no,
we're fine.
It's
we actually,
CFC,
yeah,
not...
we're actually fine. Yeah,
I always forget.
And then just Wall of Lost Thoughts them. All right, target you another 4. So down to 22. I think so. Our record was we got someone down to 11. I'm gonna start keeping track of this.
Attack!
Oh, come on, weak. Mate. Well, is that showing weakness? Is it?
Yeah, it is. I mean. Our opponent ain't attacking us right now.
No, and they're also helping us here, yeah.
You're Please. Free to draw some cards.
Oh, even better. It's time to do some science.
So what does Flood of Tears exactly do?
It bounces all non-land permanents, and if we return 4, then we can put a permanent into play. So if we play this, that will happen.
Okay, awesome.
So we do that, right?
Yeah.
Because I think we also want to have a look at what we're drawing next turn. Ready for 2. All right, down to 17. For another 2, down to 15.
Nice.
And then,
I love it. Yarok seems great because we get to put it into play with the Flood.
Yep. So, like that, right?
Perfect.
Yep.
Yeah, it's all coming together.
It's all coming together.
I mean, this deck is way too strong.
That actually is the dream. Bouncing everything with Flood of Tears, like bouncing all your creatures with Flood of Tears, and then putting a Yarok into play so you can then recast the creatures with the double. Let me synthesize
the I mean, that's just good deck building.
I mean, that's just masterful deck building. Jonas Ristamaki has really outdone himself here. So what is going on here? Where is this Bone Crusher Giant?
It's on an adventure.
But where is this one? because it was in a
on
different...
the same adventure. They were like helping each other.
But
yeah,
but no. But did you see they were in different? Party. They were in different positions. Like one was next to the chemist's insight. The other, I don't think they get along. I think they were at opposite ends of the party, staring at each other across the.
Kind of like Hagrid and Madame Maxime. Like
maybe they had a
after.
Race.
Oh no! Are they bounced? Oh no! Okay, good. I was going to say they're about to bounce the. Oh, they, so if we turn for. If we cast this and they bounce the drowned secrets in response, then we don't get to put Yarok into play.
How do they bounce that?
With Brazen Borrower.
Oh!
And then we also have to put up with a stupid animation as well, which is really going to annoy me. But we still have to cast this.
Whatever. We still have to cast Flood of Tears.
All right. Okay. All right. Milieu for two. What are they down to? 13. Down to 11. Getting close. Getting close right. here.
Just accept it.
Oh, I don't want to have to. I'm going to look. Oh, ooh, ooh, ooh.
Okay. Okay. Hold.
Oh, yes. Woo! All right. So we put this into play. And then. We did it. Boys,
nice.
We did it.
Nice.
We did it.
Oh, on the board.
Flood of Tears. What a card. And rank up to Silver 1. That's right. You saw. Silver 1. Oh, baby. In many cultures, silver is actually considered superior to. Silver is, it has many uses that other precious metals don't. We don't have time to get into all of
Name
them here.
Name 7.
Listen, I'd love to. I don't have the luxury of Googling things
we
while we play like you guys.
Here.
Yeah. So silver does tarnish, like unlike gold. It's harder than gold. So like if you wanted to make a like some knuckle dusters, you probably wouldn't want to use gold.
I mean, yeah, if you want to make a really hard puzzle, you can just make it out of silver.
Make it out of silver. Or, you know, you want to make it out of, like, diamond. That's really hard. So, Jamin, I assume you don't want me to play this?
No, just keep it.
All right.
No reason to mill them for two.
No reason to mill them for two.
When you can mill them for four.
Okay, that's good. We're going to draw two cards at some point. Love that.
We could also not play anything and then just... surprise them that we're melting, and they draw and draw and draw.
Yeah, exactly. Get them with that big surprise finish. Should I? No, I'll just play this tapped.
No. Now, big question: if they had scryed something to the top, would we have played Apprentice?
I don't think Probably. So. All right. It looks like it's
okay.
Dance of the Man's time.
That's also bad.
Oh yes, it is. Oh dear. There's not like if
but
you,
as,
if
I
you would ask
easily.
But if you would ask me about standard like graveyard decks in standard right now, we're recording this literally minutes after the ban has just happened on Field of the Dead, so like we're pretty up close to, you know, the current standard format when you're watching this, assuming you're not watching this like in 2 years time, in which case welcome, I hope the world is still in one piece and not hasn't been irradiated by nuclear fire. I didn't think there'd be this many graveyard decks. Look, we played two Acolyte Phoenix decks. We're playing now a Dance of the Man's list.
It's the Might of the Silver.
That's it. All the hard silver decks. That's right. Oh, man. And also, we're not drawing lands.
Nah, we're really missing out on the magic experience here by not drawing lands.
Yeah, instead we're drawing the mighty 13th pick, Sage's Row Denizen.
I have played Sage's Row Denizen in Constructed before.
Have you really?
Yeah, it was at a time where I didn't play particularly good decks.
So, like last week or the week before or when?
Ha 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 ha.
Ha, 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 ha.
Big jokes with Riley Knight. Yeah, we'll just keep passing. Attack them for two.
Are you kidding? All right.
I think we replay the mill spell. To be able to counter something.
I think so too.
Really?
Like, yeah, man. We have to do something. And also, I really, really, really want to draw a land next turn.
I mean, the ability to counter something coupled with the fact that we'll most likely draw land, then yeah, maybe you've got me convinced.
And we just milled over four of their lands as well. I'm not interested in drawing any of those.
That's cards. A power move.
That's a power move. We milled over. Look at this. Elzura's Guildgate and Tranquil Cove and a Fallout Island and a non-Fallout Plains. I wonder if this person like forgot to log in time to do the one for the Fallout Plains, or they just really, really like this Plains. I mean, it's good Plains.
I can see how you like the Plains.
Yeah. Oh, there's a time warp. Okay.
Ouch.
Ouchies.
I mean, Look at all the... Why did Arena stop in our main phase, by the way? Like,
I think just to make us feel like we had a chance of interacting. What does this card do? As long as you control four or more artifacts, it has hexproof. And tap two artifacts and you draw a card. And they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 artifacts.
I mean, what fools they are to draw cards.
Yes, exactly. We're also going to take 5. Just say go?
Yeah.
Maybe mill them? How many cards are in the graveyard?
5.
But 5. I don't see how milling gets any good.
Yeah, no. Not really.
No, we can wait. We can take 5. We can take 5.
Take 5, guys. Take 5.
Sponsored by Dave Brubeck.
Who's that?
Probably one of the people on Take 5.
Wow. No, it's not. So what is Take 5? What do you think Take 5 is? I know what it is, but what do you think it is?
Wait. Yeah. Oh, no. Is it a song? Oh, yeah. No, it's a song.
It's not a song. It's like a jazz. It's a very famous jazz piece.
A sample, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know why I mistook that.
But
dumb.
But there's probably a band. Well, not now, but yes. There's probably a band or something called Take 5, right?
Probably.
I'll hope so.
Yeah, exactly. No, Take 5 is a very famous. You probably recognize if you heard it, Toffol. Even though I know you are like an uncultured swine.
Excuse me?
No, did someone call for beef on this show?
We kind of inter-show beef.
I mean, Take 5, take this. No, actually, no, not Take 5, because that's not a band.
Take that!
Just Yarok? Oh, very good. Yarok?
Yeah, Yarok.
Yeah, Yarok.
Thank you.
Damn it, you beat me to it. I was at the but I was too far away from my microphone, so I bailed.
Take this. The Dave Brubeck Quartet. This is our beef with you.
Do you want a beef with Dave Brubeck?
Yes.
Isn't he dead?
Maybe.
I'd love that. We can just never lose. We can never lose that beef.
That makes an even matchup.
All right. So we're currently beefing. Let's keep a track of that. What's the beef count? The beef count is 2 at the moment, right?
Who was the first? The Asian
Avenger. We've got a beef with it. I'll let him know, actually. I'll DM him to make sure he knows that we've got a beef. Because otherwise, I mean, he probably wouldn't have any idea.
Dave Brubeck has passed away in 2012.
That's actually very sad. Yeah, he was
semi-recently.
He was a jazz master. Yeah. When I went through it.
I mean, yeah, anyone knows Take 5. Like, if you have heard of jazz,
have you heard of jazz?
You have probably listened to Take 5.
Yeah.
Like not necessarily the original thingy, but
you'd recognize it, yeah.
Yeah.
Does it do elevator music or something?
Oh, baby.
That's actually surprisingly close.
We're just dead to the Shimmer Dragon. We don't have any answers to it.
This is so sad.
This is so sad. We're losing to Shimmer Dragon. This is not a destiny that I would have picked for myself.
Fun story about Shimmer Dragon.
Go on.
I was recently in Tokyo and I bought a Japanese collector booster.
Ooh.
And I mean, yeah, we don't have 6 lands though.
That's true, but that's technically an answer. Man, are we just dead?
Probably are.
I don't know what we're drawing, but you know, we'll believe in the heart of the cards. Anyway, yeah, go on your collector booster.
Yeah, and they're in Japanese, right? So I got all these nice Japanese foils, nice Japanese alternate artworks from Throne of Eldraine. And then there was this card that I just didn't recognize. I didn't know what it does. I didn't know anything. It was a Shimmer Dragon. And I had to look it up because I had never seen that card before.
I'm not surprised. Yeah, if I opened this in a Japanese booster, I'd be like, hang on, what is this card? I recognize it as the background of some of the MTGA splash screens, but
I could tell it had flying.
But
other than that,
flying and no, even the artifact theme isn't really represented on the art. It looks like it's hoarding a castle there.
Oh yeah.
If it were in white, it would have like an exile effect, like an Oblivion Ring type thing.
Yeah,
like
exactly.
You could exile an artifact
or
something.
Hoarding the thing. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. All right, drawing another card. Man, this is rough. This is rough stuff. A rough day in the office for the Arena Boys here.
Are you in the Arena Boys office? Why am I not there? Where is the Arena Boys office?
I feel like probably my office in Glasgow is the Arena Boys office.
Okay.
It's where it gets recorded and edited.
Oh, okay. But is it an actual office? Like, where are we so far?
I'm going to counter this as well. Actually, no. I don't care about that. Just resolve it. It's in Glasgow. In Glasgow, in the United Kingdom.
Okay.
It's our headquarters.
All right. So, yeah. If you want to send us a deck, write to Arena
Just
Boys
put Arena Boys HQ on an envelope. That's it. That's all you need to put on an envelope. From anywhere in the world, they'll know where to send it. Ah, now we've done it. Look at this combo. We got them. Now they don't know what's going to hit them. Man, this deck is... I thought we were getting Dance of the Manced. I really did. But we're not. We're getting Shimmer Dragon
We're
getting Shimmer Dragon. All right, let's mill them. Mill them for four. Get this list for another. This is Future Riley. You can have a look through this list and see all the hot and spicy tech in there. Man. I don't know. Actually, I don't know if my Dignity can stand being dealt lethal damage by a Shimmer Dragon.
A Shimmer Dragon. I don't think there's any shame in losing to Shimmer Dragon.
No. It's not a Shimmer Dragon after all.
This reminds me of the days when Aetherling was a card and all the games were basically, I play Aetherling. Okay, I die.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And if you want to be really conservative, you'd play Aetherling with two blue up instead of just one.
Tuffle, you once won a PTQ finals in an Aetherling mirror, didn't you? Not by playing Aetherling, but instead by looping Sphinx's Revelation and Elixir of Immortality at like 1 a.m. in the local game store.
That was fun. Yeah, My opponent was, I think, had two Aetherlings.
So they attacked you for like 10 or 20 every turn.
Yeah, and I just shuffled more. Like, I could also do some tricks and thinging around. Like, it was pretty awesome.
Sounds like hell on
just
earth.
So you know, the way that Tuffle qualifies for the Pro Tour.
Yeah.
Then also, this was really mean because it was a friend of mine, and we were building the decks together. And I think he was playing two Aetherlings, and I was only playing one. And the last minute change of me was putting the second Aetherling in the deck, which he didn't know. I did it right before.
You zucked him.
Decklist submission.
Took your second one out, right?
What?
No, did you just said that their opponent played two Aetherlings?
Yeah, and I played one in the sideboard. Yeah.
Okay, I see.
I think. And so I played my first one and get countered, and then he thought that I didn't have anyone in my deck. So he tapped out and I played the second one.
You zucked him. You zucked your mate.
No, that's mean. That's mean. That's Tuffle. Yeah. That's Tuffle style.
I mean, it's a bit sad. Like,
it's very nasty. You're a nasty boy.
Yeah, but it's very legitimate.
Should I go and get a forest?
Probably.
Yeah. I don't know if we're going to cast this Assassin's Trophy or anything, but look at these four colors as well, just like that.
The Might of the Goose.
Yeah. Absolutely. The Goose is, in fact, not loose. Are they going to attack? That would have been a power move. Right, so
I mean, if
good game. Good game. I agree. Magic is indeed a good game. Forest?
Forest.
All right. Get the single forest we've got there. Could come back to bite us on the bum if we have multiple blue spells to cast, but just Ashok him, right?
Yeah.
You mean as soon because they don't die right now?
Well, the Ashok.
I mean, something is happening, right? What are they casting? The wolf?
Maybe like the Flash Wolf, but no, they don't play four color Flash. That would be ridiculous.
Oh no, the four color Wolf deck. PV played it in a Phantom Legends thing. It's got Tulsimir and Garrett Cursed Huntsman. So it actually could be exactly that. You might be right.
So I think we just play the Denizen thing and then see what happens.
Okay, let's mill them.
They could also have like the counter guy. Right.
The Frilled Mystic. We saw one of them in the graveyard. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. We could have looked at the graveyard to gain some information.
They did that, and they've also got Realmcloak Giant. Wow, this is a spicy
playing
one.
The White Castle in their deck. That's ambitious. I would call that.
There we go.
Okay. Nice. I mean, I'll accept that. I will accept my Sage's Row Denison getting a counterspell out of their hand. All right, no attacks.
Also, they had to use their food. They also milled two in the process.
Yep, I'd say we're up on that. Okay. Four color wilderness reclamation.
Ooh. Okay.
Man, I really would have liked to draw a land there.
Let's just do Ashiok.
Yeah, I guess now we can do that.
Nice. Get him.
Well, the trigger happens anyway, right?
I think it went fast enough that they didn't have a response. Oh, no, they obviously did.
I got you. Yeah. So now this drown the lock thing.
Yeah.
Perfect combo.
Very, very strong indeed.
Unfortunately, drown and lock doesn't even combo with drown secrets. Because,
are you sure?
No, it's not worded like pyroblast. You know, pyroblast says destroy target permanent if it's red or if it's blue.
Oh, so yeah, you can't even target anything. Yeah.
Oh, that's so sad.
So we have to time it so we have to go like Wall of Lost Thoughts, Drown of the Log, then activate Ashiok.
I guess the Ashiok problem will solve itself pretty quickly.
We should also probably kill the Wilderness Reclamation.
I don't know. Does it do that much harm right now?
I guess without very many cards in hand. I don't know. It's just one of those cards. It's just a lightning rod. It's like Mirari's Wake in Commander. You see it, you're like, nah, get that out of here.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, our opponent can attack Ashiok. Oh, Malika. Oh, it's not... I mean, it's fine.
Yeah, they're not pressuring us in a huge way. Also, they're drawing cards. Yeah, what fools they are.
Cut them down. What fools they are, indeed. I like that. Okay.
They ride into Austria. You
must be
Okay.
So I think we...
Oh, Ashiok, one final time.
All right. Okay, and then Wall of Lost Thoughts so we can drown and lock something.
Yep. Yeah.
Okay, that's exactly. All right, yep. All right. Rend their dreams asunder. Sweet Ashiok.
Wow, Arboreal Grazer in that deck. I am confused.
And then Wall of
Standard
Lost
decks
Thoughts.
At this point still, like, they're just cards. I
I mean, that's generally, like, generally speaking, that's true. They are usually just cards, yes. All right, I mean, how what do we got?
Spectrous Sailor, Arboreal Grazer.
I think, do you know how I think our opponent built this deck? I think they were walking along, like, maybe in their FNM or something. They're just hanging out somewhere. They were holding their trade binder. I'm going to counter that.
Yeah, please do.
Counter.
And then they slipped.
They slipped, dropped their trade binder. All the cards fell out, exactly 60 of them. And they were like, hang on a second.
No, not 60. Like 50 of them, and then someone else slipped with their draft deck. And like...
they bumped into each other. Yeah. All right. This, by the way, is the only spell that doesn't trigger Drown Secrets in our entire deck.
So now someone else is walking around with a draft deck that got mixed up with like 10 cards out of the trade binder.
Yeah, it's a draft deck with a bunch of powerful rares.
I don't
want
to play against them in Limited.
No. Although, actually, it'd be pretty easy because you just call a judge and be like, hey, they have a War of the Spark rare in their Throne of Eldraine draft deck. All right. What do we need here?
Maybe Yarok.
Yarok would be a decent.
How many cards do they have in their library?
16.
16?
It's not too much.
It's not many. Do you want to kill this?
No.
No, I don't want to either. No. All right. Okay. That's something.
That's a powerhouse.
I've never been more excited to draw Sage's Row Denizen, and I'm not that excited to have drawn it. We got him.
Ooh.
Dang. Wow.
We did it.
What?
Cannot beat the Sage's Row Denizen. What a...
I mean, who has ever beat it?
I mean, like, exactly. No, I would say it doesn't. It's not a card that gets beaten very often, Jamin, because it's not a card that gets played very often.
Maybe.
This is crazy. How did that happen? They just didn't have any win
Apparently
options?
Not. Apparently not. So if you actually... If we discount the losses that we had, right? We actually finished with a winning record. We've actually finished undefeated if we ignore the times that we lost. So this deck is very, very powerful.
Yeah. We're 3-0 so far, right? Or 2-0?
2-0.
2-0. I mean, games took pretty long, given that like we're at like...
Yeah. 50 minutes plus. Games. Exactly. Yeah, exactly right. But look, don't worry about that too much. Thank you so much, Jonas Ristamaki, for sending in the list. He also included a sideboard, if anyone wants to have a look at that. Obviously, we play the purest form of Magic. Just best of one, as Garfield intended. But if you want to play it in best of three, here's the sideboard that that Jonah suggested. And of course, there's a deck out on CFA right now, so you can go and get across it there like that. A lot of fun, this deck. But, man, like, you're not, let's be honest, you're not going to win a lot of games, but you will assert your dominance. Milling people out is, you know,
I don't think you assert dominance by milling people out. I think you assert dominance by attacking with Merfolk Secret Keeper.
That's what I was talking about, man. That's what I was talking about. You can attack with this. You can even register Sage's Rodenizen in a constructed deck, and if that's not a power move, I don't know what is. Anyway, we're done for another week. Once again, thank you to Jonas Ristamaki for sending in the list. If you've got a list you want to share with us, please send it in as well. The best way to do this is on Twitter. My DMs are open. You can find me at Riley Grutow, or you can contact the show directly at The Arena Boys. And make sure to jump on Twitter and follow us all. And let's get this beef heated up. Let's pop this beef in the microwave and start... I'll message Krim before he starts getting all these like joke hateful messages from our fans, so he realizes it's coming. But yeah, Asian Avenger, we're coming for you, so you better watch out, because we're gonna say some real.
We're gonna attack with some Merfolk Secret Keeper.
You're aware that we're literally making a feud with somebody that's called Avenger.
That right? is a very good point. We're actually giving him things. Which he can
but
abandon.
What's Avenger, anyways?
Right, right. Maybe we should just start. We should have started the beef with Jamin.
I mean, this is not good.
Yeah, exactly. He's going to listen to this. He'd be like, "All right, I don't even need to worry about these boys. Like, this is going to be the easiest beef in the history of all time." Anyway,
I'll just wait and they destroy themselves.
Exactly. Anyway, we're done. Make sure to follow us all on Twitter. I'm Riley Corey Tower.
Wait, sorry. I just remembered. Wasn't there like a war that was like a few seconds or something?
There was a war that lasted for a few minutes. Yeah,
I think this is our goal.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We'll see how long the beef lasts. But anyway.
Well, I know Jamin. The beef doesn't last very long usually.
Just say your Twitter handle.
Eat it.
I get it. I get the joke.
Yeah. Your Twiddle handle.
Perfect.
At TuffleMTG, you got it.
And at Jackomatris at this point. Shoutouts to Timothy Stoneman for sending through more Mario Maker levels. I'm always taking them.
Oh, sweet. Yep, they're still coming in. All right, good. Anyway, we're done. We'll see you back here next week for more Silly Nonsense. Send in your lists, please do. And until next week, be nice, be care to each other. I don't know, we've already got an outro. It's time to exit the arena.
Boys!